to now we have discussed some word problems in exercise 3.6. The next topic in this chapter is relation between addition and subtraction. So what is the relation between addition and subtraction? So addition means, what is the meaning of addition? So addition means put together. So addition means put together, that means combining. So addition means put together, that means combining. We will combine two or more objects, or we will combine two or more numbers, that means addition. And what is the subtraction? So subtraction means taken away. Subtraction means taken away. That means we will take away from some objects, from the given total number of objects. So if we take away some objects or some numbers from the given total number of objects or given total number of the numbers. So here, if you observe the, or if you understand the meaning of addition and subtraction, so these both are relatively opposite to each other. So here addition means put together, that means combination, combining. Subtraction means taken away, that means we are separating. So addition means combining, subtraction means separating. So these both are relatively opposite to each other. That means both are opposite to each other. Now let us see an example to understand the relation between addition and subtraction. So let us see a small example. So what is the addition of 2 and 3? So now we will add 2 and 3. So here I will put plus symbol. Plus means addition. Now we have to add these two numbers. So addition means combining. Combining means put together. We have to put 2 and 3. Then we will get addition sum. So now add 2 and 3. How much you will get? So if you add 3 to the 2, how will you add? So if you add 3 to, we will get 5. How will you get 5? So what is the second number here? 3. So open 3 fingers of your hand. And what is the first digit? 2. After 2, what will you get? 3. So start counting from 3. 3, 4, 5. So the answer is 5. So you have already learnt in first class and second class how to do these additions. So if you add 3 to the 2, how much you get? You got 5. The sum is 5. So this is called addition. Now, if you subtract this sum, that means if you subtract 5, so write 5 first and subtract any number. If you subtract any number in this addition, that means if you put taken away 2 from 5, so write 2 here, then what will you get? That means I have written 5 in the first and I have taken 2 as the second number. If you subtract the first number from the sum, then you will get the second number in the addition. So children, are you able to understand here? So here I have added 2 numbers, the answer is 5, the sum is 5. Now I will do the subtraction. What subtraction? So now I will subtract any one of these 2 numbers from the sum, then we will get other number. Now I will subtract the first number 2 from the sum, then I will get the second number 3. So let us check whether we will get 3 or not. So if we subtract 2 from 5, so how much you will get? So subtract 2, open 5 fingers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and close 2 fingers, 1, 2, so how many fingers are there? There are remaining 3 fingers, 1, 2, 3, so write 3 here. So you will get the second number. Done. So let us see once again. Here the sum of 2 numbers is 5. And if we subtract the any number from the sum, here 2 and 3 are 2 numbers. I have added 2 numbers, 2 and 3, and I have got 5 as sum. And subtract any one of these 2 numbers from the sum. So write 5 first and write any one of these 2 numbers and subtract. Again you will get the second number. Here 5 is the sum and 2 is the one number, and then you will get the other number. So this is the relation between addition and subtraction. So that means both addition and subtraction are opposite to each other. If you add 2 numbers, we will get the sum. And if you subtract any two, any number from the sum, again we will get the other number. So in this way, we can do or we can check the subtraction also. So by using this property, we can check our subtraction, whether our answer is correct or not. So by using this this property, we can check our. So we can check our subtraction by using addition, and we can check our addition by using subtraction. Here the sum of 2 and 3 is 5, and we can check whether our sum is correct or not. That means whether the answer is correct or not. Here 5 is correct or not. How can we check? So if we subtract any number from 5, we will get other number 3. So the answer is correct. In this way, we can check our subtraction by using addition, and we can check our addition by using the help of subtraction. So let us see an example. How can we check our subtraction? So checking of subtraction. So how can we check subtraction? So check subtraction by using addition. Check subtraction by addition. So children, so let us see an example. So how can we check our subtraction by using addition? So let us see an example. So take two numbers. The two numbers are 3451, and the second number is 1320. So children, so these are the two numbers. Now I will subtract these two numbers. So let us subtract these two numbers. So this is ones place. So these are in tens place, 4 and 3 are in present in hundreds place, 3 and 1 are present in thousands place. So let us subtract first. So start subtract from ones place. Here 1 and 0 are present in ones place. So now subtract 0 from 1. So if we subtract 0 from any number, we will get again the same number. So the answer is 1. Now go to tens place. So 5 and 2 are present there. What is the first number 5? Open 5 fingers of your hand, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the second number 2? So close 2 fingers among these 5 fingers. I have closed 2 fingers. Chalo, how many fingers are there? 1, 2, 3. So 3 fingers are there. Write 3 under tens place. Next, go to hundreds place. What are the digits under hundreds place? 4 and 3. What is the first number 4? Open 4 fingers of your hand, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, what is the second number 3? So close 3 fingers among these 4 fingers. 1, 2, 3. I have closed 3 fingers. How many fingers are there? There are 1 finger. So write 1 under hundreds place. Next, go to thousands place. So what are the digits present in thousands place? 3 and 1. What is the first number 3? Open 3 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3. What is the second number 1? So close 1 finger among these 3 fingers. So children, how many fingers are there? 1, 2. So there are remaining 2 fingers, so write 2. So children, this is the difference. So this is the subtraction and this is the answer. Now we can check this answer. So this is the difference. And we can check this subtraction by using addition. So that's why we have to write this difference first. So how can we add? So we can check this subtraction by using addition. What we have to do, how can we add? So add the greater number to the difference, then we will get the smaller number. Here, the first number is the greater number. So this is the greater number. And this number is smaller number. This is the smaller number. Now, add greater number to the difference. So write what is the difference here. So write difference first. So what is the difference? 2131. So this is the difference. And write greater number. Add greater number to it. So add greater number to it. What is the greater number here? 3451. Then what will we get? So add this number. So put the symbol plus. Add these two numbers. So write the places first. This is ones place, tens, hundreds, thousands. So children, how can we check? We can check our subtraction by using addition. So what we have to take in addition? We have to add greater number. That means we have to add first. first number in the subtraction to the difference. Add the first number to the difference. So write the difference first and add the first number. Then we have to get, that means we have to add the difference. So that is the smaller number. Then we will get the greater number. So add the smaller number first. Write the smaller number. So write the difference first. So this is the difference. Write the difference first. And we have to add the smaller number. We have to add smaller number to the difference. What is the difference here? 1320. So this is the smaller number. Then we should get greater number. Then our subtraction will be correct. So how can we check our subtraction? By using addition. So what we have to add? So we have to add smaller number to the difference. So write difference first and add the smaller number. Then we should get the greater number. Then our subtraction will be correct. So add 1 plus 0. If we add 0 to any number, we will get the same number 1. Now go to tens place. Add 3 and 2. What is the first number 3? And what is the second number 2? And open two fingers of your hand. 1, 2. What is the first number 3? So after 3 we will get 4. So start counting from 4. 4 and 5. Answer is 5. Now go to 100's place. What are the digits in 100's place? 193. So what is the second number 3? Open 3 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3. What is the first number here? 1. After 1 we will get 2. So start counting from 2. That is 2, 3, 4. The answer is 4. Next go to 1000's place. What is the first number 2? What is the second number 1? So open one finger and start counting from the first number. That is, after 2 we will get 3. That means if we add 1 to any number, we will get its successor. What is the successor of 2? 3. So write 3. So what will we get? We have got the greater number. So we have got the greater number. So now our subtraction is correct. Our subtraction is correct. So children, in this way we can check our subtraction by doing addition. By doing addition. So how can we check? So we can check our subtraction. We have to add the smaller number to the difference. We have to add a smaller number to the difference. Then we should get greater number. So this is the checking of subtraction by addition. Children, good morning. Up to now we have discussed the subtraction of 4 digit numbers with regrouping and subtraction of 4 digit numbers without regrouping, and also we have discussed how to estimate the difference of 2 numbers and how to compare that difference with another number. And now we are going to discuss the relation between subtraction and addition. Already we have discussed in earlier episodes. So the relation between subtraction and addition. And how can we check the subtraction by addition? We can check our subtraction by addition. That means we can check whether our answer is correct or not. So if we subtract no numbers, we will get the answer. And we can verify whether the answer is correct or not by using a simple addition. So let us see an example for the checking of subtraction in the exercise 3.7. So we will practice some problems. In exercise 3.7, how to check the subtraction by using addition. That means how to verify our answer by using addition. So children, so see exercise 3.7. So this is Ankit's test paper. Check his subtraction using addition. Give him a star mark. So children, this is a star mark. So give him a star mark for every correct answer. One is done for you. So children, so look at the problem. So here you are observing some subtractions in the sheet. So this is Ankit's test paper. So he done in some problems. So he has done some subtractions. Now we have to verify his subtraction. That means we have to check his answer, whether his answer is correct or not. So how can we check his answer? We can check his answer by using addition. So now let us see the first problem. So they will given a subtraction, and how to check his answer also given in the first problem as an example. So first see the first problem here. He has taken two numbers. That is, the first number is 379 and the second problem is 223. So these are the two numbers. Now we have to subtract these two numbers. Now then we will get a difference. We will get an answer, and we can verify that answer by using simple addition. So let us see how to verify our answer. So let us see how to verify our answer. So children, let us start the subtraction from ones place. So what are the digits present in ones place? 9 and 3 are present in ones place. So what is the first number? 9. So open 9 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Children, these are the 9 fingers. What is the second number in the ones place? 3 is the second number. So close 3 fingers among these 9 fingers. Children, see, I am closing 3 fingers. 1, 2, 3. Now children, how many fingers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 fingers remaining. So write the 6 under 1's place. Now go to 10's place. So here, what are the digits in 10's place? 7 and 2 are present in 10's place. So what is the first number? 7. So open 7 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Children, these are the 7 fingers. And what is the second number? 2. So close 2 fingers among these 7 fingers. So close 2 fingers. 1, 2. I have closed 2 fingers. Children, how many fingers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 fingers remaining. So write 5 under 10's place. Next, go to 100's place. What are the digits present in 100's place? 3 and 2. What is the first number? 3. So open 3 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3. And what is the second number here? 2. So close 2 fingers among these 3 fingers. So 1, 2. I have closed 2 fingers. How many fingers are there? So there are remaining 1 finger. So write 1 here. So children, this is the difference. So this is the answer for the subtraction of these 2 numbers. Now we can verify this answer by using addition. So how can we verify our answer? So simply you have to remember that we have to add the greater number, that means we have to add the smaller number to the difference, then we should get a smaller number. We have to add smaller number to the difference, then we should get a greater number. So greater number means first number, smaller number means second number. So children, see, this is the greater number. So this is the greater number, that is the first number is the greater number, and second number in the subtraction is called smaller number, and this is called a difference. Now we have to add the smaller number to the difference, then we should get a greater number. So if you get a greater number by addition, our answer is correct. So let us see how to verify. So first write a difference. So what is the difference here? 156. So first to write a difference, the difference is 156. So write 156 first. And add smaller number to the difference. What is the smaller number here? That is, what is the second number? 223. So write 223 here. 223. So we can verify our difference, that means we can verify our subtraction by using addition. So what numbers we have to add? We have to add the smaller number to the difference. If we get the greater number, the subtraction is correct. So first write the difference and next write the smaller number, we should get the greater number. So now add. So this is addition. So we can verify our subtraction by using addition. So start from ones place. What is the first number? 6. Second number is 3. So open 3 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3. Now start counting after from first digit. What is the first digit? Is 6. After 6 we will get 7. So start counting from 7. 7, 8, 9. So the answer is 9. Right, 9 in answer place. Next go to tens place. What is the first digit here? 5. And what is the second digit? 2. So open two fingers of your hand. 1, 2. And start counting from first digit. So what is the first digit? 5. After 5 you will get 6. So start counting from 6. That is 6, 7. So the answer is 7. So write 7 under tens place. Next go to hundreds place. So what are the digits present in hundreds place? 1 and 2 are present in hundreds place. So what is the second digit? 2. Open two fingers of your hand. 1, 2. And start counting from the first digit. What is the first digit here? 1. So after 1 we will get 2. So start counting from 2. That is 2 and 3. So right answer 3. So children, what number we have got? We have got 379. That is the greater number in the subtraction. So 379 is the greater number in the subtraction. So our subtraction is correct. Here we have added, so the smaller number to the difference, and we have got the greater number, then our subtraction is correct and our answer is verified. So in this way we can verify our subtraction by using addition. So while verifying or while checking, we have to add the smaller number to the difference, then we will get a greater number. So then our subtraction is correct. See the next problem. So the next problem has two numbers, 700 first number and second number is 265. Now we have to subtract these two numbers and we can verify our subtraction by using addition. Here the symbol plus means symbol. Symbol plus means addition. So first do the subtraction, next do the verification. So subtraction means minus, verification is addition. So first do subtraction. So what are the digits present in ones place here? So 0 and 5 are present in ones place. So 0 and 5 are present in ones place. We cannot subtract 5 from 0 because 5 is a greater number, 0 is a smaller number. We cannot subtract greater number from the smaller number. So here subtraction is not possible, then what we have to do? Subtraction is not possible, then we have to get borrow from its next place. What is its next place? Tens place. So how many tens are there? 0 tens. That means there are no tens in the tens place. That means there are 0 tens in the tens place, then we cannot get borrow from the tens place because there are no zeros in the tens place. And we cannot get borrow from the tens place. So if you cannot get borrow from the tens place, that means if there are zeros in the next place, then go to next place. What is the next place? 7. So that means get borrow from hundreds. That means what is the next place? Hundreds place. How many hundreds are there? There are 700. So get borrow from 700s. So if you get borrow 100 from 700s, how many hundreds will be there? There will be 600. So write 6. So if there are no digits in the next place, then go to next place. If there is also zeros, then go to next place. Continue this process until we get a digit. So here, next go to hundreds place. There are 700s. Get borrow 100 from 700s. If you get borrow 100 from 700s, there will be 600s. So now carry 100 to the tens place. Carry 100 to the tens place. So if you carry 100 to the tens place, it will become how many tens? It will become 10 tens. So simply write 1 before the digit. So that means there will be 10 tens. Now how many tens are there? 10 tens are there. So get borrow 1 ten from it. So if you get borrow 1 ten from 10 tens, how many tens will be there? 9 tens will be there. So write 9 here. And carry 110 to the ones place. If you carry 110 to the ones place, then how many ones will it become? It will become 10 ones. So simply write 10 here. Now the subtraction is possible. Subtract 5 from 10. So what is the first number here? 10. So open 10 fingers of your hand. That is Open 10 fingers of your hand and close 5 fingers among these 10 fingers. So open 10 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Chalo, these are the 10 fingers. And what is the second number? 5. Close 5 fingers among these 10 fingers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Children, I have closed 5 fingers. There are how many fingers remaining? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are remaining 5 fingers. So write 5 here. Next, go to 10th place. What are the digits present in 10th place? 9 and 6 are present in 10th place. What is the first digit here? 9. So open 9 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And what is the second number? 6. So close 6 fingers among these 9 fingers. So close 6 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Chalo, how many fingers are there remaining? There are 1, 2, 3. So 3 fingers are remaining. So write 3 here. So next, go to 100 space. What are the digits present in 100 space? 6 and 2 are present in 100 space. So what is the first digit? 6. So open 6 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So children, so these are the 6 fingers. And what is the second number there? 2. So close 2 fingers among these 6 fingers. So close 2 fingers. 1, 2. I have closed 2 fingers. Children, how many fingers are there remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are remaining 4 fingers. So write 4 here. So the difference is 435. Now we can verify this subtraction by using addition. So in addition, what we have to do? We have to add smaller number to the difference. So first write the difference. What is the difference? So first write the difference here. That is 435. So first write the difference. Next, add the smaller number to the difference. So what is the smaller number here? 265. So 265 is the smaller number. So write 265. Now do the addition. So let us start addition from 1's place. So 5 and 5 are present in 1's place. So what is the second number? 5. Open 5 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And what is the first digit here? 5. So start counting after from first digit. So after 5 you will get 6. Start counting from 6. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the sum is 10. So the sum is 10. But the sum is has 2 digits. So this 0 is in 1's place. 1 is in 10's place. And write 0 in 1's place. And this 1 is in 10's place. So carry this 1 to the 10's place. So carry this 1 to the 10's place. Now there are 3 digits under 10's place. So now first add 2 numbers. Next add the sum to the 3rd number. First add these 2 numbers. That is add 3 to the 1. So if you add 3 to the 1. So if you add any number. If 1 is added to number. We will get its successor. So if you add 1 to the 3. We will get its next number. What is the next number for 3? 4. So the sum is 4. Now add this sum to the 3rd number. What is the 3rd number here? 6. So open 6 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And what is the sum we have got? 4. So start counting after 4. After 4 we will get 5. So start counting from 5. That is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again we have got the sum 10. Again we have got 10. But the sum has 2 digits. If the sum has 2 digits, carry the 10th place to the 10th digit. So here, this is the 10th place, this is 100th place. So write 0 in 10th place. Write 0 in 10th place. And carry 1 to the 100th place. So carry 1 to the 100th place. Now add first 1 and 4. There are 3 digits under 100th place. 1, 4 and 2. So now first add 1 and 4. If you add 1 to any number, we will get its next number. What is the next number for 4? 5. and add this sum to the third number. What is the third number? 2. So open two fingers of your hand, 1, 2. And what is the sum we have got? 5. So after 5, we will get 6. So start counting from 6. 6, 7. So the sum is 7. So children, what we have got? We have got the greater number. That means we have got the first number. So the subtraction is correct. So put star mark here. So the subtraction is verified and the subtraction is correct. So our answer 435 is correct, because if we add the smaller number, that means if we add the second number to the difference, we have got the first number. So in this way we can verify our answer. We can check our subtraction. Third problem. So there are two numbers given in the third problem. That is, first number is 823. Second number is 243. Now we have to subtract these two numbers and verify our subtraction by using addition. So if we add the difference, that means if we add the second number to the difference and if we get the first number, our subtraction is correct. The simple way of checking our subtraction is simply add the answer to the second number. And if we get the first number, our subtraction is correct. If we don't get the first number, our subtraction is wrong. So let us do the subtraction first. So go to the subtraction for ones place. What are the digits present in ones place? 3 and 3 are present in ones place. Subtract 3 from 3. If we subtract 3 from 3, the answer is 0. Because according to subtraction properties, if we subtract a number from the same number, we will get to 0. That means 3 minus 3 becomes 0. Now go to tens place. What are the digits present in tens place? 2 and 4 are present in tens place. So subtract 4 from 2. So is it possible? No, because 2 is the smaller number, 4 is the greater number. We cannot subtract 4 from 2. So that's why what we have to do, if the subtraction is not possible, then get borrow from the next place. What is the next place? Hundreds place. What is the digit present in hundreds place? 8 is present in hundreds place. That means 8 hundreds are there. So get borrow 100 from 8 hundreds. If you get borrow 100, then will be, how many hundreds will be there? There will be 7 hundreds will be there, and carry 100 to the tens place. If you carry 100 to the tens place, 100 will becomes 10 tens. So the 10 tens, and there are already 2 tens, total becomes 12 tens. So simply write 1 before digit. So if you carry, means if you get borrow, simply write 1 before the digit already present there. There is already 2, so simply write 1 before it, then it becomes 12. So now do the subtraction. So what is the first number here? 12. What is the second number? 4. Subtract 4 from 12. So now this is the 12 and we have only 10 fingers. We cannot do this subtraction on our fingers. So just to draw 12 lines in your notebook. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So just draw 12 lines. And what is the second number here? 4. So strike off 4 lines among 12 lines. So strike off 4 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have strike off 4 lines. Children, how many lines are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are remaining 8 lines. So write 8 under 10 space. Now go to 100 space. What are the digits present in 100 space? 7 and 2 are present in 100 space. So what is the first number? 7. Open 7 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 7. These are the 7 fingers. What is the second number? 2. So close 2 fingers among these 7 fingers. So children, see, I am closing 2 fingers. 1, 2. I have closed 2 fingers. How many fingers are there remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 fingers remaining. So write 5 under 100 space. So the answer is 580. So now we can verify this answer by addition. So what we have to do? How can we do addition? So first, add the second number to the difference. So this is the difference. So write the difference first. 580. So write the difference first. and add the second number to the difference. So what is the second number? 243. So now add the second number to the difference. If we get the first number, that is 823, then our subtraction is correct. And if we don't get the first number, our subtraction is wrong. So let us do addition. So here, what are the digits present in ones place? 0 and 3 are present in ones place. So now add 0 to 3. According to properties of addition, if we add 0 to any number, again we will get same number. So if we add 0 to 3, we will get 3. Now go to tens place. What are the digits present in tens place? 8 and 4 are present in tens place. So what is the second number here? 4. Open 4 fingers of your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the 4 fingers. What is the first number? 8. So start counting from 8. After 8. So what will you get after 8? After 8, 9. So start counting from 9. 9, 10, 11, 12. So the sum is 12. So cancel the first digit here and carry it to the tens place and carry the first digit to the hundreds place. So carry the first digit to the hundreds place. So children, if the sum of the digits is the sum of the two digits is again two digits. So if the sum of the number is two digits, so cancel the first ones place. So cancel the first digit and write it under tens place and write the next digit, carry the next digit to the next place. So here 1 is in hundreds place, so carry the 1 to the hundreds place. Now there are 3 digits under hundreds place. What are the 3 digits? 1, 5 and 2. So first add 2 digits, that is first add 1 and 5 and the sum will be added to third number. So first add 1 and 5. So if 1 is added to 5, we will get its next number. According to properties of addition, if 1 is added to any number, we will get its next number. What is the next number to 5? 6. So the sum of the 1 and 5 is 6. Now add 6 to the 2. So what is the third number here? 2. Open 2 fingers of your hand. 1, 2. And what is the sum? 6. So after 6, we will get 7. So start counting from 7. So 7, 8. So the answer is 823. So this is the first number. So here we have got the first number. So our subtraction is correct. So put star mark to the so children, in this way we can verify our subtraction by using addition. So how can we add? First we have to add the second number to the difference. If you get first number, our subtraction is correct. If you don't get the first number, our subtraction is wrong. So practice remaining problems at your home as a homework, which are given in PDF.